Okay, so the first thing that you need to know about Botox is, what is Botox? So I've covered that in here, but the question that came in with this was a little confusing to me because I really wasn't sure what they were asking. Watch the difference between, and I pronounce this as Lafort, so I'm hoping that that's what that is. And we got that screen coming up. Let's see if I can make this bigger. Okay, so this I'm pronouncing this as Lafort. That is actually a person's name. And what he did was he came up with this type of maxillary or facial fractures. And so this Lafort 1, 2, and 3 is the type of fracture. So here they are. This is the classification that I came up with from the screen. Let me just scroll down here for you can get a better view. There's a little bit of delay on my screen. So here we have a Lafort 1 fracture. See how that goes just over the maxillary bone there? Underneath here, this lower jaw is called the mandible, but between the top row of teeth and the nasal cavity there, that's the maxillary bone, the maxillary bone. So here, this Lafort 2 fracture is actually above the nasal sinus between the orbit of the eye, and then this Lafort 2 is... it's going above that nasal sinus, but it's going inside the orbit of the eye. So you can see how that is a much more severe fracture. Let me scroll down here a little bit more on this page, and you can see a side view of that. Again, see how that fracture on the Lafort 1 just covers the maxillary. Then this arches from the sinus. Doesn't really have a lot of orbital involvement, but goes down into the maxillary bone. And this one doesn't involve the maxillary bone, but it has all of this orbital involvement, which is a much more difficult fracture, I would think, to heal. But that's what the Lafort 1, 2, and 3 stands for. Now, what does that have to do with Botox? Well, let's talk about what Botox is used for. Now, the first thing that most people think about is Botox. Women get that for those frown lines in between. If you can see my picture where I'm rubbing here between your eyebrows and the crow's feet on the side, or, you know, we call them laugh lines, you know, on the side, the little crinkly lines that you get when you smile. But that is... what that actually does is it numbs or relaxes the muscles there, and Botox is actually a type of poison. It's from the botulism, which is a type of food poisoning, and it relaxes or deadens muscle is what it does. So what it does when they inject it, it doesn't anesthetize it. It numbs the muscle so that those lines disappear. Okay. Well, when they were doing this, when they found that it worked for that, they also found that it worked for several other things, like, let's scroll down here, cervical dystonia. And this is actually a condition in the muscles of the neck causing the head to twist. And it's actually a really painful disorder. But they would be able to inject that this Botox into this cervical area, and it would deaden or numb that muscle to stop it from contracting. And then people could straighten their heads up. And also it works with lazy eye. If you've seen people that had one eye that sways off when the other eye doesn't, and so you know your eyes move and track at the same time, but let's say your left eye foot goes forward and your right eye tracks off to the right, well, sometimes it's called a lazy eye, and there's conditions that distinguish it as a lazy eye versus something else, but they can go in and inject the muscle that takes care of this imbalance. Now, there's also other things like muscle contractures for cerebral palsy. You've seen the children that have cerebral palsy and their arms and legs will be severely drawn in from contractures, and they can give them these injections and that will loosen these muscles up. Let's see, this other couple ones is this hyper, now I may not pronounce this correctly, hyperhidrosis. And this is actually when people sweat a lot, and you know, we don't really think of that as such a common thing, but for some people it's excessive. And not only is it just the excessive sweating, you know, but you smell bad, but you also are just soaking wet. Some people have this on their feet, but also on the underarms. They can go in and give them these injections of Botox, and it literally dries this up because it deadens or stops that that area from producing the muscles. Another thing that it's used for is chronic migraines, and to classify for chronic, it makes a note here to say 15 days in a month. Now, there's all different types of migraines, and for example, I 15 years ago was diagnosed with having migraines, but I don't have migraines like other people. My migraines is kind of like an ice cream headache, but I have all the other signs and symptoms of migraines where I get blurred vision and dizziness and ringing in my ears, and it goes on for days and days and days, whereas my son, who has epilepsy, when he gets a migraine, he's the kind of the classic where, you know, he has to throw up and he wants to be cocooned in dark area, no sound, no light. Well, oh dear, I lost the page. So they found that Botox will help that. Okay, there we go, it's back. Now, another thing is bladder dysfunction. They found that it will help with incontinence. These are things that, you know, before we thought, it's all about, you know, cosmetic, but it's not. They found that this this Botox is able to assist with several things that we may not have even thought of. But the great thing is that there's codes for that now. So let's talk about some of the coding that can be done with this. Okay, let's scroll down just a little bit here. A couple codes that I pulled out is, what would we code as an example of a, let's say, migraine? So what they call that is actually a chemo, or they're calling it, it's for chemical denervation, I'm going to say that incorrect, I'm sorry, of muscle, okay, bifacial, cervical spinal, and accessory nerves, bilateral, and it says for chronic migraine. Okay, a specific code that's used, 64615 for chronic migraine. And then you have a code. Now this code is indicated when you look up 64615 that says if you need a code for guidance, then you need to use this 95874 for a guidance code, and then you need to let them know what you're actually using, and this J0585 is the injection code for Botox, and this is the chemical name for Botox, one unit. And this is a HCPCS code, okay? And this, I don't know if I'll be able to pronounce this Botox term. Botulinumtoxin. That'll be fun for the person that's transcribing this for the replay club to try to do. But this is actually the term for Botox, okay? And these are the codes that would be used commonly if you're coding for a migraine headache and you're giving them Botox injection for a chronic migraine. Now, again, let's go back up as we end this slide to talk about what does that have to do with this Lafort fractures. Well, when I was doing a little research, these Lafort fractures, they do Botox to deal with some of this, and they also do Botox for something that's called a gummy smile, and this Lafort 1 is what that is when people smile and on their upper lip their gums show when they smile, and so they'll inject right along here in this Lafort fracture line Botox, and what that'll do is it relaxes the muscle so that the lip comes down and relaxes, and then when they smile their gums don't show, just the teeth. Anyway, it's called a gummy smile. So I think that was why the person that submitted this question might have was combining this Lafort, 1, 2, and 3, also wanted to know about the Botox procedure. Otherwise, I was kind of left as to questioning, what the significance was as to why they were combining these two things. So that's about all I could find on those two, the Botox and the Lafort fractures.
Need more medical certification training? Go to www.codingcertification.org.